subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on our updates and get notified about our new videos.
And so I'm Swarnalata Devarakonda. I work with Manipal ProLens since 4+ years now. I work as a head of program for cloud technologists. My primary responsibility is to engage high profile participants who has come to learn cloud technologies. So before I deep dive into, you know, talking about, okay, you can become a cloud architect or you can become a cloud engineer, first let's understand what is cloud computing, what is that I am talking, so that you could actually derive out a meaning at the end. Yes, this is the technology will definitely rule the industry in next, you know, I don't say next few years, this would be the technology will live forever, that I could say, because the industry is looking for storage. Storage is a big concern. We have more of social media, WhatsApp and Facebook and Twitter pages. So big data has come into place. So since I hope, I'm not looking at your background right now, I'll just assume that, okay, we all know about these things. There might be one or two freshers who have joined, even, you know, this program is applicable even for that cohort, because the entire industry is making a shift to cloud. So cloud has become a big buzzword. So what is a cloud? So that is something that we have to understand before we move on. So before we move on, what is a cloud? Just understand the today's, the business scenario. I just told before even moving to this slide, I mentioned about we had big data coming in and, social media stuff and all that. So what is today's business scenario? Today's business scenario is unpredictability and competition and demand of collaboration. Multi-application integration is required, and high infrastructure cost. That's the one toughest part every organization is facing today. And more than you invested on high infra cost, people will end up in maintaining that. So that is a high cost of maintenance and availability, risk, and security. How about whether my data is secured or not? So I have to actually, if you are running a physical data center in your organizations, your logbook has to be maintained. People who's going in and coming out, how much time that they have spent inside the data center, whether what is the data being used, you are not allowed to carry pen drive, nothing. So many security threats were there, and cloud security is the biggest topic. So we are not going to jump into all that right now. And the another concern, as I mentioned, about the big data, right? So this is the current business scenario. It is very tough for any business to maintain everything. One side, the business has to have a good infrastructure. The other side, they have to run their business by putting good business executives to make a good business. So the organization will end up in a big confusion. Do I have to invest so much to maintain my infra? Is that my core area, or running my business is my core area? So maintenance of this infra can be taken over by many giants, like say an example of AWS, Google, or Azure. So let me give that part to my service provider. Let me focus on developing my business. So you being a businessman, if you want to run your own website tomorrow, you don't have to worry, I am just doing a business of, a small, like say an online trading center, or an online shopping center, my focus should be to sell the goods, not to maintain my server or not to maintain the infra or the computer to be in a dedicated room. So I don't want to do that. I want to get out of all that, then focus only on my selling business. So that should be my focus. So what I have to do for that, what is the required thing to be done to meet that demand today? To answer that, any organization has to maintain their data in two forms. One is as on-premise, the other one is as either in cloud. Today, these are the two different IT models. These two IT models helps us to secure our data. The on-premise is the one what I just mentioned about data center. The other one is the cloud model. So as per the today's trend, all the on-premise versions are moving on cloud. So everything gets moved on to the cloud. So what is this cloud? So why people are moving on cloud? What is this actually going to give us? Just look at one before I again deep dive into what is cloud. Look at the history. If you just see in 1950s, there was a boom on mainframe. Everyone started learning, okay, I must learn mainframe to get a good job. So mainframe has come in. Everyone have gone behind mainframe and started learning, mainframe. I could even say that's the time this automation phase actually has started and everyone were behind mainframe. It was a huge, huge computers were maintained. Even today, mainframe is green. So many organizations learning mainframe because of that robustness of that the structure of mainframe technology. Later, we moved on to PC desktop era. You all could have seen that white big bus in every organization where we call it as a desktop PCs. It was actually ruled as even in 1990s in India. So this statistics I'm just considering from the US side, but India, instead of 1960, it would be 1980, I could say. Or in even 1960s, very few organizations had computers. Later in 1990 was that real IT boom has come. During this boom, Y2K problem has come. Too many IT offerings have opened up and client server architecture being done. Everyone started learning, okay, learn Java. So if you learn Java, you will get a job. So that was, the scenario in 1990s. And there were so many, on-site recruits as well. Then we had, when hosted environment is something which started in 2000. Here, the concept of virtualization has started. So VMware, hypervisor concepts have came in. Cisco had their own hypervisors. So all these virtualization concepts have started in 2000. But in 2010, all the virtualization concepts being turned as a service model. So this is the time from 2010 onwards, the as a service model, which has been matured, people needs to know. Still, I could say, though it is started in 2010, how many of you are aware of this as a service model in 2019? So at least now, this is the time for you to focus on to learn about what is as a service model. So as a service model is a model, IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. So I'm over here. I'm just highlighting. I will just annotate that. So these things, this is an infrastructure as service, platform as service, software as service. So these three are, different types of services from the giants that I'll just give you a glimpse of what is IaaS and what is PaaS and SaaS in the next coming up slides. And let me move on to the next one. So with all this, we learned, now we are in a cloud era, right from the mainframe era, then PC era, and then we moved to, a client server era, then virtualization era has come. The present era where we are is a cloud era. So are we learned this cloud? No. So is it not necessary for us to learn cloud? Yes, so it is the right time. If you are not already explored what is cloud, is the right time for you to concentrate on cloud. So with that, so what is cloud computing? The cloud computing means either it is internet or network. So this term is not new to us. Right from 1950 main era, we could call this as a network. But in today's era, we're calling this as cloud. That's just, they have renamed internet, because your entire IT infra, just imagine. I just have one question. Please ping back in the chat window. How many of you have come from IT side in this today's cohort? I could see 20 of you joined. So you don't have to give me detail about your organization. If you are willing, then even that is fine. Are you come from IT organization or from a healthcare or from, you know, banking? So can you just know from where you have come from? Okay, yeah, Bhaskar said IT. Yeah, that's great, Bhaskar. So most of you are from IT. So this is the right cohort. So the cloud is present at remote location. So now, you know, like I hope most of you would have even visited your data center. Amresh also from IT. I think all of you have come from IT. So that's a very, a good cohort that I got today. So whatever I talk, definitely, I am hoping it will reach you. So since you have come from, an IT background, you might have visited your data center. Just imagine you are going to move your data center remotely. So that remote place we are calling as cloud. So the organization can get rid of maintaining their own data center. The entire infra for an organization can be made it available using the technique called infrastructure as code. Someone else has developed a software. If I need 4 Ubuntu machine today, just log into any one of the service provider, just pass a parameter as 4. I need a 4 Ubuntu machine for me. The Ubuntu machine will start available and running for me immediately within few clicks. So for your organization, you can extend the infra using infrastructure as code within few clicks. So that is the technology being developed. And I really personally amazed so much when I being a part of this technology and when I really start running my VM. So I feel so happy. How come someone can do, bring in such a great evolution? So this is as an IT person, so though I have 20 plus years of experience in IT organizations like Infosys and Unisys, now with Manipal. So I personally enjoy creating VM. Whenever I do this as a task, that's a wonderful journey for me. So I hope even you should get that. You should definitely start learning this technology. So example of some common application is, we are not far from this technology. In day in, day out, all of us are using this. Like one such example is iCloud. It's an Apple product. OneDrive from Microsoft. Most of the organized IT organizations, our organization is using OneDrive to take our entire laptop as a backup. If something goes wrong with my laptop tomorrow, it's very easy for me to replicate everything from OneDrive to my new laptop back. The reason for all this evolution is, even the Google Drive, actually what is available for you on your mobile is that supports synchronization of your files across platforms. Probably in my laptop today, I would have used Windows, and tomorrow I'm going to use Ubuntu as my operating system. Am I able to get my file structure access from Windows to Ubuntu? Yes, my files are available for me from the storage that what we have used. It could be Google Drive or Dropbox, or it could be OneDrive or iCloud. Dropbox is partnered with the Samsung, and Samsung provides you Samsung Cloud to back up all your mobile data. So I'm just talking only from mobile data. Just imagine we being an ordinary person, when I carry my mobile today, like tomorrow, I don't want to lose my data when I change my mobile from iOS to Android or Android to iOS. I want all my pictures, storages, and WhatsApp messages back to my machine. So I depend on, you know, a Google Drive or an iCloud kind of an storage area from there where I could retrieve. So if that is the case for a normal, you know, a person like us or a professional like us, just imagine an IT organization, if they want to, how much they want to secure their data. So not only IT organization, I could even say healthcare. Healthcare is another important sector where they need secured storage and secured infra for them. And banking is another sector. It could be a government bodies who wants to keep their data for ever and ever and ever. So they want to actually storage places like, you know, a cloud. So to bring in that huge mass storage area, the service providers are helping us. The service providers are AWS and Azure and Google. And if you see, they run a physical data center for us at multiple locations across the world. AWS has around some 18 different regions. In 18 different regions, 54 plus availability zones they run up there. Availability zones are called as data centers. So rather you maintaining your data center, it is coming from AWS data center. That's, it comes to us, that entire infra remotely. So we'll call that it's on the cloud. So this diagram is just a very self-explanatory exam. I hope you would be able to learn out of this. So am I boring folks? Are you want to have any question to me? Do you have any questions? So what is the cloud? What we can actually expect out of the cloud? So I can actually, you know, use an online storage data, online IT infrastructure, online software applications, platform independency, and flexi pay as you go. So this is a very important thing. It is kind of a, you know, see today everything is on utility based. You have Ola, you have Uber. So if I use Ola for 2 kilometers, I'll be charged based on my kilometer that I used, or if I travel for 20, and even I have an outstation Ola. So similarly, like today, if I need 2 machines, I'll be charged accordingly. If I want 4 machines with say some 10 CPUs, then I'll be charged accordingly. Instead of, you know, 40 GB, if I want 400 GB, I'd be charged. So based on my consumption, I will be charged. Tomorrow, if I think, okay, I don't want anything, I can quickly go and close everything so that I will not get charged further. So in case, just imagine if I want to run a small organization, like as I said, online shopping center, I need an upfront investment to make my infra ready. My server has to run. I have to recruit a technology guy who can maintain that infra, then my website will, you know, up and run. So now being a developer will be given access to cloud. They can put in their cloud thing. So that doesn't mean that this infra jobs will vanish. So that is not the case. What means the infra people has to scale up on the cloud based infra. The developer people should know how this infra being built and how their applications are available, and the the consultants, whoever is in a consultant role, so they should know how this infra is formed, how the hands-on on the infra could be done. So this consultant could be a sales consultant, or it could be a developer as a consultant. For a sales consultant, it's very, very important for a sales pitch, and for a developer, it is important for a you can even go as a cloud trainer. Cloud trainer is another big domain where people are minting, you know, money today. So these are like that. So too much of opportunities available for you, being like every industry is moving on cloud. So over here, I just have put up some of the cloud computing service provider. Amazon, Google, IBM, Microsoft, Cisco, Dell, and HP. So did you guys, among this cohort, do you have any base knowledge in cloud? And some of you have done already some R&D. And are you looking any specific thing from today's webinar? Please feel free to send in chat window. So any one of you are already cloud architect, Subhashish said AWS. That's great. Okay. Nutanix offer what cloud? Okay. Rajendra, okay. That's great. Okay, so Subhashish says Redshift. Yes, Subhashish, that is a part of AWS course that we will offer. Okay, that's great, Subhashish, for pinging your interest. Yes, that will be addressed in the course. Anything else? So how about others? Like, I'm just getting only few pings. Project managers, yes. So before I go to the next place, Subramaniam is asking how cloud computing will be applicable for project managers. So under you, the developers are going to work, and you are the one are going to guide the developers who is going to code on cloud. So it's very important for you to understand or even demand something from your team tomorrow why this was not delivered. So it's very essential for you to understand, you know, what is cloud computing. And I will not recommend, you know, you learn everything, whatever being the service provider being put up here. In our curriculum, we have picked up Amazon because that has the highest demand in the market. So based on that, we are recommending Amazon. At same time, we'll also give a glimpse of Google to you. So because Google is again another leading competitor in cloud service provider. So we will touch base these two technologies, just not these two technologies. I have a slide for you. What is that you have to learn to excel in this technology? So in that I can go more deeper what you really have to learn. So Amrish, if you don't have even a base knowledge, you don't have to worry, because in Manipal's curriculum, you will start from the scratch. So just to give you an introduction of what this service providers providing us and why we are behind them, I just have one small example, make your own pizza. So if you want to make your own pizza, you might need all this components. You need a dining table, soft drinks, electricity, micro oven, toppings, sauces, and dough. So just imagine I'm going to make my own pizza at home. I have to keep everything ready. So today, if the organization has to deliver a pizza, they have to keep all these line items ready with them, and the maintenance of line item has to happen to get that pizza ready. The next is, okay, I'm okay with the frozen pizza base, what I buy from the market. So that is another option that I have if I have to make pizza. I will not make dough at home. So I depend on an external guy who gives me dough, who gives me sauces, who gives me some toppings. Then I'll heat it up. Then I need some electricity to make it more attractive. I will buy some soft drinks. I'll eat it on a table. Okay. So this is up to me which service that if I make my own dough, I might need that upfront investment. If I'm going to buy, if I know my need is only 10 pizza bases, I'll buy only 10 pizza bases. So there may be some cost saving and then that effort saving. Both will happen. The next is, I don't even want to make it out of a base at home. I want to buy a ready-made pizza, which I will order online, which comes to my home. So at my home, if I want to sit and have pizza, I just have to take care of two line items. One is manage my soft drinks and I have a good table to eat. The remaining things, the pizza guy who's coming and delivering will take care of me. Of course, that is, it will be little chargeable. The taste will be fine and you will really enjoy the taste. Okay, I even don't want that. I have another option of visiting pizza restaurant. If I visit restaurant, everything is available to me. I don't have to worry about any infra, right? Everything is available to me in a ready-made format. So why I had put up this slide to you is, I mentioned about as a service model to you, one is infra as service, then platform as service, and software as service. So just want to compare your today's thing, the data center, which is maintained by an IT organization. They have to maintain all of this. They have to maintain their applications, storage, runtime, middleware, OS, virtualization, servers, everything they should take care. But in cloud, we have a different choices. I can leverage only the infra part, or I can leverage the OS part, or I can leverage the software. So in the infrastructure as service, storage, servers, virtualization, operating system will be ours. On the virtualization, on the VMs, it could be that VM would have created using hypervisor, what operating system. Then the people has to install their own middleware, runtime. Middleware could be your Apache server or WebSphere or WebLogic. Then you have to take care of your runtime. If you run any Java application, you require JRE. Then you have to take care of your own data, and then the application storage, of course, you can leverage from IaaS vendors. So there are multiple vendors available. The service providers are Amazon and everyone. And from these vendor, different model of the services which is available. So in our program, you will get introduced to all of these services. Then if you go for a PaaS platform, you see you have a privileged two more services being given by a PaaS vendor to you, and runtime and middleware. And if you go to SaaS, everything is available for the organization and you will get billed based on your usage. So the organization can get rid of upfront investment. What if you are an IT guy, you have to, your job is to oversee how many your employees are joining per quarter. Based on that, you have to keep the system ready for their project work. Then what will happen? People have to upfront invest for that 100, but later on you see only 10 are joining. Then that 100 investment will go waste, and you have to wait for more time to fill in that 100 system. By then the technology will change, your system will go an outdated model. So that's the biggest challenge that every organization is facing today. So then that, okay, I have an option of, okay, I see only 10 are joining, go just log into AWS, pick up 10 machines. So my job is done. I don't have to worry anything. So if he is a developer, give him with the required software. Prefer a SaaS platform. What has to be pre-installed on that machine? You have lot of images running. Like say, if you want to do a deep learning, okay, then some TensorFlow software would have been pre-installed. As a project manager, you can make a decision. What should be my pre-installed software? So you just can select that required image in the marketplace in AWS. That system will be up and ready within few minutes. And you, in case if you want to give us access to your client or to do your UAT, so all that would be much more easier. Where you can even expose some of the open links if you are going to place your data into a public cloud. So we have seen there are three different types of a service provider: who provides only infra, who provides with platform, who provides with all the required software. You also have a different deployment model. We'll go more deeper in the real class. So we just want to give you a glimpse about, if it is public, it is accessible to everyone. If you want to put your website. Thanks, Subhashish, for the feedback. So you have a public cloud, and you have a private cloud, you have a hybrid cloud, and you have a community cloud. So these are the different public cloud model which is available. Public, yeah, if it is public. Today I am doing an open webinar for all of you. You are not a part of Manipal yet. So that is a public webinar I am doing. If I am going to do only for my cloud joint cohort, then it will be my private. Okay, in your, when I do a webinar to my cloud batchmates, in that webinar, if I add you, that's going to be an hybrid. I'm doing only for Manipal today. If I want to do for the other organizations as well, then that goes as a community. So that is public, private, and hybrid and community cloud that we have. So we have just seen the glimpse of what is cloud. We understood there are different cloud models, and we have three different types of providers available: IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. Then we have let's move on to the next topic: cloud current trends. So these are the report, very recent report that I have taken. RightScale is a body. Their job is to publish the strategy about the latest technologies. It could be on cloud, or it could be on data science, or it could be on AI. Okay, so they keep publishing reports on about the latest technology and the trends. If you have some time, please visit a RightScale website, and even you can download and see what is the latest trends in cloud. So as per that, the trend that what I see from 2015 till to date, always the top one is AWS. The next leading person is Azure. Google are slightly late in the market when compared to Azure and AWS, but still they could occupy 18% of the adopters. So this is actually a survey. This is based on consideration of number of people who's responded. I think some 1,000 organizations have responded to their survey report. So AWS is the one always leading. So from the responder, 19% are new to at beginner level, and 32% have adopted intermediate, and 31% at advanced level. So now every organization started, adopting cloud. And I see, I just want to mention one thing. The company that I visited, they just asked me, Swarna, we have a requirement of 1,500 people to scale up on AWS. Do you have a course for us? So that's the demand from a B2B organizations today. So you all have come here to this session. By now you would have realized the need of cloud. So that is something pulled you in today's session. So that itself this point I just wanted to include that is also in current trends. So as I mentioned earlier to you, this is about respondent by industry. 1,001 plus employees out of that 997 organizations, 53% are having 1,001 plus employees, and 23% of employee between 100 to 1,000, and 1 to 1,000 is 24%. See, 1,000 plus, I would actually put with the larger enterprise. So the enterprises the percentage enterprise adopted cloud is very high. So then, the other side, but definitely this percentage will go much higher and higher. There are other sectors also. It's just not only the tech side. See, from the software side, so far adoption has happened only 23% so far. If you see, like as I mentioned earlier, healthcare, business services, education, even we adopt AWS cloud to run all our e-learnings. Manipal has an online platform which runs on AWS cloud. Then telecom and financial services. So every sector started looking at cloud, and this percentage is increasing year on year. And we also spoke about different public cloud, private cloud, hybrid cloud. So the public cloud adoption is always higher. This is actually a data from 2015 to 2016. So if you see in every, that blue bar is almost higher. That is an indication of every year the adoption of the cloud is going more and more. And a very important thing is the cloud architect roles. This is actually a comparison between a developer architect role. It could be an IT architect, or it could be even a cloud architect. The cloud architect percentage is increasing in the industry year on year. If you see a comparison between last year to 2018 data, since this is only Feb, I just want to present only 2018 data to you because I can't present the 2019 data right now. So that is a 61, that is a consolidated 5% of increase. So if I see after a few months in 2019, I'm sure that percentage would have increased to 5 more. So architect roles are increasing. So if you are a project manager, or if you are a developer, you can definitely aim to be a cloud architect soon. Yeah, so with that, we have seen some current trends. So we understood we have all the giants, cloud architect roles are increasing, and there is an adoption for public and private and cloud different models. So what is that I have to learn? What is the skill sets required to excel in the field of cloud? So that's a big concern for all of us, right? So to answer that question, you should have a very good knowledge in cloud computing essentials. So that is the foundation. So this foundation will help you understand. I just given you IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. What do they provide? You have to go deeper in understanding of each of these model, and you have to understand the different public model in what scenario you have to adopt which model, and you should also understand what is a cloud security aspect. So those will give you a complete package of understanding cloud computing essentials. Then I also spoke about what is IaaS and PaaS and SaaS. So that's what I said. So not only just learning that essentials will not help you, you have to go deeper in all these three technologies to understand what it does. So for the IaaS side, I'm just calling in a short form. Some people will not prefer to call that as an IaaS, but I used to call it as IaaS, PaaS and SaaS. So Cloud Foundry, so Pivotal Cloud Foundry, it is an example for a PaaS platform. And OpenStack is an example for an IaaS platform. SaaS, it is actually, it's an example of an, of course, AWS provides you all three IaaS, PaaS and SaaS if you just use Elastic Beanstack or, a SaaS platform would be available to you. So for the IaaS, you can have a good exposure to OpenStack. That's actually, though it is a previous technology, you will learn a very good grip of running your own VMs, how to configure VMs, in what scenario you can run the required number of VMs. So this technology will help you. Pivotal Cloud Foundry. If you have some time, you can log into Pivotal Cloud Foundry platform and check. So in Manipal curriculum, we address all of these three. Then AWS. So we will actually take you through hands-on with the lab guides, all of this with a scenario-based lab guide. All this learning will make you a complete cloud professional. So once you become a complete cloud professional, you can target to look for the career options, what is available in this zone. So when I talk about career options, so before even I tell you what are the career options available, let's look at what are the career trends in cloud computing. So if you want to discuss about the career trends, so when I'm talking to you, just parallelly open one window and type in Google the top skills of 2019 LinkedIn. Just type that. The hottest skill of 2019 on LinkedIn global also you can give. Or just type, see over here I have typed, you can see this, the top skills of 2019 LinkedIn. The first name will come up as cloud computing. Okay. So, and I'm just keeping the screenshot from 15, 16, 18, 19. There, since there is a space crunch, I deleted 17. So my intention is to tell you right from 15 onwards till 2019, the top niche skill to learn is cloud computing. Just look at the Indian story. So LinkedIn, we can't actually consider it's an Indian story. Is there any international participant in today's call? Can you please type from which location that you have joined in case if you are outside of India? Anybody joined outside of India today? But my existing cohort, it's having a multinational cohort. It is, and the participants' experience ranges between 14 to 25 years of experience, who's already a cloud architect, who's already working on Cisco Cloud or IBM Cloud, are learning this course. So that's the the level that Manipal will deliver to you. So this is actually a self-explanatory. I have even given the source of these informations so that you can just go and see what is the stand of cloud in Indian story. So in today's cohort, I don't see any of you joined out of India. So this story is applicable to all of you. So cloud will definitely rule industries like IT, ITES, banking, healthcare. So that's from Microsoft Asia Digital Transformation Study. So with that, so this annotated one is not going. So please ignore this annotated one. So with that, what are the different career prospects you have? You can look for cloud architect, cloud software engineer, cloud sales professional. We do have a high participant and as a sales professional from one of the reputed company undergoing our course. He's a sales professional. So he want to do a better sales pitch. So that's the reason he's learning in depth of cloud offering. You can be a cloud engineer, developer, cloud system administrator. You can even go as a cloud trainer, cloud corporate trainer. People are so busy in delivering one of this, and some of you would have definitely arranged this training for your organization, and I'm sure you would know the budget that your organization would have shed for this particular program to be arranged for you. So there are so many career prospects to you. So what makes the PGCP cloud computing, all this time I was telling, we are offering a cloud computing program to you. What makes us stand out from others is the labs that we give you. So we give you, it's a blended model program. We will take you through right from cloud essential. We'll touch base on IaaS as one full-fledged course, PaaS as one full-fledged course. Then we'll also introduce emerging technologies, because in today's digital era, anyone having cloud knowledge needs to have emerging technologies knowledge as well. So we'll touch base on introduction part of DevOps, IoT, machine learning, and big data. Then we will take you on to the prime course, that is AWS Foundation and Architecture. That's a deeper course with lots of hands-on to be given, and I'll come to that pillar. Rao, you asked what is MAHE. MAHE is Manipal Academy of Higher Education. Earlier, it was called as Manipal University, but as per the university norms, no private universities, deemed universities can call them itself as a university. So everyone has to rename themselves as Academy of Higher Education. So we are Manipal Academy of Higher Education. Earlier it was Manipal University. So you will get a PGCP cloud computing from Manipal Academy of Higher Education, which is powered by AWS Educate. AWS Educate, it's a body of AWS. We have tied up with them to get you the cloud labs. So you will be given two different types of cloud labs. So this is your curriculum. This is a 6 months long program. But I feel personally, anyone to excel in any one of the subject, that 6 months is the good time and sometimes less time even to excel. But our CRISP curriculum, the one which we have already tested with multiple high profile participants, will definitely would help you to excel within the required time. Beyond all that, just remember, we can actually take you till the water. You have to drink the water on your own. It's not that the moment you join us, you will get excel. The dedication, the urge in learning will definitely make you a good professional. So that's what I keep always tell to my existing participants as well. You have come here for learning something. Please better use your time with us. So this program would be delivered to you online, and you have for all the topics e-learning along with 12 hours of lecture hour. This 12 hours of lecture hour we would deliver in the form of a webinar. The webinars, each webinar is of 2 hours duration. So for every course, you will have 6 webinars being developed by multiple SMEs. At the end of this program, so if you just see the first program, like if you just go back and remember the chart that what I have put up. So if you see this chart, you have to learn Cloud Essential, IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. So let me just compare that here. You will learn Cloud Essential with some good 6 sessions of webinar. And Cloud Open Source Platform is the pivotal Cloud Foundry. In the same module, we will introduce Google concepts as well. Then you have an OpenStack platform. The OpenStack platform will introduce the entire OpenStack platform. On that, you will do your hands-on practice on AWS Educate Cloud Labs by running your own VMs. And see, if you just go to the other vendor, they might limit the cloud labs. So, but here you have an option of getting a 1 year access from AWS Educate. Even after you finish your 6 months of program, that access will be available to you for 1 year, either 1 year, or there will be some free credits of $1 would be given to you. That might keep changing, but as of today, that is $75 from AWS Educate. So whatever AWS Educate gives us, the same thing we will pass on to you. So that $75 credits, if you finish it early, then your lab session would be over. Or if you don't finish it even after the program being done, the labs should be well managed. All that, we will guide you. So far, none of the participants come back to me telling my lab is expired. So you will have sufficient time to do your labs. And since we are targeting working professionals, our sessions, webinar sessions, we are doing it over the weekends. So the current batches are running on the weekend. So we will provide, login for your, that's what I said, AWS Educate Cloud Labs, we will enable it to you. On that, you can do your practicals. And when you move on to, AWS Foundation, that DevOps and IoT part, another higher lab also we will provide you. So that is, if it is needed, we will provide. So it depends on, concepts you are trying. There will be another, lab. Also, that support also you will get from us. So the one thing what you have to remember is you have to finish all the e-learning and you have to attend webinar sessions. Webinars are enablers for you to start off your lab. Most of the part would be addressed in e-learning itself, but still As per our statistics, we see some of them are struggling to start their lab. So in the webinar session, we will make you to start the lab. We will give you all the foundation. With that foundation, you would be able to do the assignments, whatever we give it to each topic. And the next is, I was talking about MAHE, right? Now you have seen the 6 months, 25 weeks curriculum. So each topic would be given sufficient time to you to go through. And in between, if it is necessary, we will give some logical pass to start a session, next course. But if we feel, okay, you all are doing good, if it is not required, at the same time, we'll also push you to finish within 6 months, because just because you joined us, you can't do this course for 1 hour. Anything, everything will go by Manipal University norms, because you are not just doing single course with us. You are going to gain a qualification, which you can put in your resume as well, that you have done a 6 months long program as a postgraduate certificate program from Manipal University. You have even that option as well. And you have to score 40%. Then at the end of the program, you have to meet some minimum norms. You should be a graduate to undergo this training. From this cohort, is there anyone who's not graduate? Graduate with 50% you should have. And at the end of the program, you should have at least 40%. So these are all some internal computations. The moment you onboard, we'll help you with what is the minimum criteria that you should meet in every course to get that. So then you will understand the way we deliver, because we would be monitored by university bodies. Are we doing a good, neat delivery to you or not? So we are also under surveillance from the university side, because you are gaining a university degree, just not like a small vendor who's just doing a 2 days course for you in AWS and sending you back. So that is an advantage for you. But at the end of, since I said we are partnered with AWS Educate, there is an option for you logging into AWS Educate website. You can also go through their e-learnings as well. And because if you finish any of their career path, there is a possibility for you to earn some e-badge even from AWS Educate, which you can put up even on your LinkedIn page. You'll also have an access to their job boards. So these are some additional things. And at the end of every course, there is a question about exam from Rajendra. So at the end of every course, we will give one final assessment. Each course has its own module level quizzes. It will have some lab guides. You are required to do all that. You have to do your assignments, what is being given in the course. Then you have to complete your final assessment, which being given. So at the end of the course, your internal score is, we'll consider 70%, external though 30, but you should have a minimum of 40% separately you scored in your external. So there is some calculation in that I can give you once you onboard on this program. And every course comes with some credit. So at the end of the course, you will gain some 16 credits certification from Manipal University. So we are partnered with AWS Educate. As I said, you have an option of getting their e-badge. You also get, today it is $75 credits, which AWS is giving us. Tomorrow they may give 60 or 80, but whatever they give, you would be given. So you don't have to worry about your lab part. That amount is sufficient for you to do with your hands-on. When it comes to our delivery part, we will give you, since I said it is an online and blended model program, you have to learn from e-learning. You have to attend webinar. So you might be thinking how all these are going to fall in place. So this is giving an access to our Manipal ProLearn platform. This is our open website. Just log in, go to visit our Manipal ProLearn website. You would be able to see our all online program. And you could be able to log in once if we give you a registered email ID and password to you. Again, I just want to stress on this point. You have to access all the e-learning. You have to attend interactive webinars. You have to finish the scenario-based hands-on exercises to have a complete learning and turn yourself as a cloud professional. So it's a glimpse of our platform. So you could see an introduction to cloud computing. In case some of you will not have, you know, fundamentals of networking and Linux, these we think as an essential. But I am sure this cohort, you know, it's a very special cohort who's joined today. I see everyone are come from IT background. So I am thinking we don't get that challenge. But even if some of you like think, okay, no, I have learned it long back. Give me some bridge course on this. I will give you a course on what is networking and what is Linux before even you start our program the moment you sign up with us. We also run a help desk. Like today, how we are operating is we will, all the cohort of your batch, like say in case I'm going to form all of you in one batch, we'll create a WhatsApp group. So all our main concerns even can be addressed using a WhatsApp group. And we're in a help desk, a mail ID will be given to you. We'll also give that escalation points to you so that you can reach out people if something is not working out for you well. So that's how that completes my today's presentation. So I think I'm talking for a very long duration now. This is your time now. If you have any, queries in your mind. First of all, like before I even take your queries, I would like to know from you how many of you are interested in this program. Can you please send in your interest level in chat window, please? So I'm not hearing anything. Yeah, thanks Balaji for your response. So are there anyone? Thanks Mahesh. Yes, Sachin. Yeah. Yes, Pillara, thanks for your interest shown. So are there anyone else who's interested to join? If you have any queries in your mind, you can ask me now. Okay, so any other questions? Yeah, course fee, Subhashish, my team will reach out to you. They will also, Samanvay, do you want to say something about that? So the team will reach out to you. This is not the forum to talk about or to discuss about the course fees. Yeah. So yeah, that's a very important point, Mahesh. If you miss any webinar recordings, every webinar, even today, what I'm delivering to you is getting recorded. And that will be hosted back on our LMS. So you have seen our LMS view, right? So here for every course, every recording would be made available to you. It's not that just you missed it in case if for your future reference, in case if you don't understand some of the concepts when the faculty is delivering, you might want to replay and learn. So for that sake, we'll made it available, all the web recordings to you. So Pillar of Azure, we are not offering that as a full-fledged, course, but in any one of our webinar session, we can try to give a fundamentals of Azure learning to you. Placement assistant after the course. Arjun, there is a job portal access for you from AWS Educate. So that portal will help you to know across the world what is the requirement from AWS side for cloud. So that itself a bigger bigger help to you. So I think, I hope you all could see our product manager Samanvay's message. Yes, Judge, definitely. So that's what I'm just giving you an example of the current cohort. People who is doing data on cloud migration using Cisco Cloud already are learning our AWS Cloud because that's the demand from their client. And an IT infra guy who is supporting multiple organization is a part of one of our cohort. So we have a rich participants who is learning from us, and definitely you will enjoy learning. Yeah. So Samanvay is message something to you. I hope you could read that out. Pilara, I will cover many topics, depends on my availability. But there are multiple lecturers available with us. I don't call them as a lecturer. They all are SMEs. SMEs who are cloud practitioners today will deliver the sessions. So another important information to you is we are going to launch a batch coming Sunday. It's a new batch we are launching. We have already high participants profile who is a part of that course. I just was go throughing their profile, who's having 22, 25 years of experience in IT industry are learning this. So if you want to get on to the same batch, otherwise you might have to end up in waiting for one more quarter or 2 or 3 months time. So this is the right time if you are looking for to join. So Samanvay, please reach out to the participants. I think in fact to everyone, just not only who said interested today. This is the right time and good opportunity for you to, the moment you think you can start off. Otherwise, we have to, make you to wait. If you come little late to us, you have to really wait when that new batch will commence. So you all are so lucky, but just before the batch commences, I'm doing this webinar to make you understand the significance of it. So it will be, easy for you to, get the right thing at the right time and what you want to do it immediately. So Pilara, I am not understood your question. Was expecting intro on cloud. What does constitute hardware? It's not very clear to me what is that you're asking. Yes. So cloud is, the cloud meaning, if you ask me, I'll just say it is a network or an internet. Cloud is something which is available in remote location. So remotely, your mission will come to you. See, I have my laptop today, but I will be logging to a remote mission and I'll do all my application installation and all my project development in a remote mission. So it is an hardware and software application. If it is a software application, if it is only hardware, it is IaaS. That hardware comes with operating system, PaaS. If that it comes with software, then it is SaaS. So AWS, he is a service provider. So you have a Airtel, okay? From Airtel, you can buy a SIM card. You can use that SIM card for how long that you want to use. Once if you don't like Airtel services, you can throw that SIM card, take Idea or other service provider SIM card. Similarly, AWS is a service provider who will give you virtual machines. You can use their virtual machines the way that you want to consume. Once your usage is done, you can close that account with them. The same case with any other service provider. So Airtel gives you SIM card, AWS will give you virtual machines with the preloaded softwares. Okay, so there was some other question in question and answer session. So I want to answer that. Okay, so Rajendra, you are an IT professional with 15 years. Yeah, that's good. That's great. Definitely you can look at this program. Yeah, so Rajendra, if you have completed only diploma, so there is a tweak in that. You can undergo this program, but you will not be given Manipal University certificate, but you will be given a Manipal ProLens certificate powered by AWS Educate. So that certificate you will get, but that Mahe certificate you will not be getting if you are not a graduate. See, if architect is the biggest role in any of the job roles, if you just see the job role hierarchy, the top role will be architect or a senior architect. So if you want, if your aim is Sridhar, if you want to become an architect, you have to learn all three. All three with any one service provider. There is one anonymous attendee. Yeah, so for the placement, already Samanvay has answered. Subramaniam is asking, for cloud computing, do we need to have software background? I do not have any software industry background. So Subramaniam, you're from which industry? What is that you're doing today and what is your experience? So I'm not hearing back from Subramaniam. So Samanvay, please reach out Subramaniam and ask for his background and we can help him what is that he wanted. So application portability across Azure and AWS is just like you change your iPhone and an Android based mobile. Pilarav, I have seen one more question from you. AWS, Azure, IBM Cloud, Google, they all are different service providers. Today, if you go to Airtel, you will have a different plans. Idea will have a different, Vodafone will have a different plan, right? Similarly, each service provider's plans are different, rates are different, pricing is different. But if I can I launch an Ubuntu machine with AWS? Yes. Can I launch an Ubuntu machine with Google? Yes, I can launch. Maybe I may be paying different pricing models with these two service providers. Depends on their pricing model. Okay. So I saw 27 Samanvay at one place. Well, 27 I have seen. Attendees. Okay, thank you everyone. Is there any other question or do you want to ask something to us? So as I told you, so we are starting inaugurating a new batch on Sunday. This coming Sunday morning 10 to 12 is our inaugural time. So I would look forward to you joining there. See, if you are an hardware support, are you an IT guy, Josh? IT support guy? You are an application. Okay. No problem, Josh. You can definitely, can join this course. Our cohort is different. Even if you just see, go to AWS site and look for the certification. They have a certification for architects. They have certification for developers. They have certification for system admins. So, architect is the highest level. So system, if you learn either developer or system admin, you can become an architect easily. Okay, so if you are an IT support guy, this is the right role for you. This is the right learning for you. Yeah, so the other important point is, I don't think I'm pushing you to join the course. After I push you to join, you should learn well. That is my primary focus. Once you are on the course. So I want you to finish the course successfully, learn the maximum out of us. So that should be your focus. So with that, I will be ending today's session. Thank you so much for patience listening and I look forward to you joining our course. Thank you everyone.
Hey, thanks for watching. Do like the video, share it, and also don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Check out exclusive coupon codes for our YouTube learners in the description and visit moneypalprolearn.com to redeem it.